Have you always wondered about the neuroscience behind happiness? Can science make you happier? Welcome to Mindset Monday. Happiness is a concept that has fascinated philosophers, theologians, neuroscientists, and cultural commentators for ages. Wanting to be happy is deeply anchored in human nature, and this has been a human pursuit for thousands of years. Despite the expansive body of research and literature, scientists are just beginning to grasp how the brain processes this emotion and the chemical mechanism by which this influences our thoughts and behaviors. Past couple of decades, positive psychology has taken this notion into the realm of scientific and academic research to better understand and get a deeper insight into meaningful living and well-being. So, how do scientists explain happiness, and can science and technological advancements make you happier? Scientists are always working to better understand the brain, our human DNA, our makeup, and our personality, how it can be enhanced and how it can be constrained. But at the same time, they're also looking at the emotion of happiness and how we can do little tweaks and have our self-talk that could possibly enhance our happiness and our well-being. Most people think that in order for them to be happy, they must acquire or encounter something big and phenomenal. But that couldn't be further from the case. Most of the time, we sit there and we think, oh, if I only had that bigger car, or if I got that job promotion, or if only I had that house, or if only I got that bonus, then I'd be happier. Actually, on the contrary, where it comes from are your thoughts and actions and a slow but daily progress and daily routines that you set that will make these intentions so much better and make you happier. So, what causes happiness? Your happiness depends on many variables. Your emotional fluctuations during the day or during a given week can depend on many personal life circumstances, your health, your finances, your relationships, etc. And how you deal with those completely determines your happiness and your state of happiness. Another way that you can increase your happiness is by giving and giving back to your community. It has been proven by research that the more giving you do, the better you feel about yourself. With that said, there is another aspect of happiness, which is the neuroscience behind it. And in our brains, we have neurological chemicals, which can vary from person to person. And those chemicals are serotonin and dopamine, which can make us feel happier or more or less satisfied with our lives and the lives that we lead. And our happiness factor. Because we are wired to pursue pleasure and avoid pain, we not only look to survive, but we look for things that give us pleasure and make us feel fulfilled. Our brain chemistry is designed to sustain these efforts by releasing happy feel chemicals into our bodies and brains. Serotonin, for instance, is produced in the brain and the intestines, and this neurotransmitter is circulated in the bloodstream and across the central nervous system. Serotonin is most importantly known for its mood regulating function. Scientists refer to this neurotransmitter as the happiness chemical, since higher serotonin levels result in higher confidence and a better sense of well-being and belonging. So what they've noticed is that in people that have higher serotonin levels, they are usually happier. Although there are many pills and medications that target serotonin levels, a 2018 study revealed that pursuing social means and pursuing happiness through gatherings and getting together socially with people actually increases the levels of serotonin much better, and it makes people feel seen, valued, and heard. So, while no one feels happy all the time, science does show that happiness is contributed to and increased by our thoughts, our behaviors, and our actions. And yes, there are some biological factors that can decrease our happiness, but it's also what we do with our thoughts, behaviors, and actions that can help to mitigate that. So, to answer our initial question, can science make you happier? Well, yes, it can, but you also have the power to rewire your brain to redirect your thoughts from negative to positive. Each week, I talk about topics that can enhance the well-being of your life. So if you like, can science make you happier today? Then click below and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That way you will be alerted each week when I upload a new video. And as well, if you could go to my website at www.amanda-desilva.com/newsletter, you can sign up for my newsletter, and that way you will also receive the blog along with the newsletter each week to your inbox. Thanks for sharing this space with me. Have a wonderful day.